Hello campervanners, I'm off down to Henley to make a video for the boating channel, and I'm going in the van because I think I might end up staying the night, so I thought I might make a quick vlog out of it and bring you along. That meant a trip along the very tedious M40 motorway before exiting at Junction 5.
Turn right onto Whipstone Road.
Then there were some delightfully narrow and entirely typical country roads where you pray you don't meet someone coming the other way. Until finally I was almost at Henley and could turn into the site where the event was being staged. It's due to be exceedingly hot today. So, notwithstanding no solar, I've parked under a tree. As have many other wise people. I try to travel light in terms of filming gear on this kind of thing. I've got this rather excellent bag I bought many, many years ago. It was on sale and I don't think they make it anymore, but it's got loads of compartments in it and is perfect for my camcorder. So I've just got the camcorder, got some new little radio microphones, the Rode Wireless Go 2, which I'll try out for the first time. And then at festival type stuff, I tend to use a monopod. This is an incredibly cheap one. I think it was about 15 quid. But it's perfectly good for just steadying up the shots you take with that camcorder, and nowhere near as bulky as a tripod. This is not only a boat event, but also classic cars. And oh my, aren't they shiny? How's this? 1957, I think the lady said it was. Does about 8 miles to the gallon, which doesn't surprise me. And since this is a camper van channel, after all, can't not film a classic VW, can you? And here's not quite chitty chitty bang bang, but you're not far off. Love the step to get in. And the obligatory horn. It's quite tempting to squeeze that, but you're probably not supposed to touch.
Yeah. It was fabulous, and then we went over to Cornwall,
Yeah, we had a wonderful. It's such an eclectic mix here. You've got two Aston Martins, then you've got an MG, and then you've got whatever that is. It's a Citroen. Well, well, well. That's not the same one I filmed before. This is its twin. Not quite, the windows are slightly different, but same kind of thing. I do like a nice open-topped classic two-seater. Never owned one, but it is the life's ambition to have one day. And modern classics as well as lots of old ones. Back in the days when engine bays had space in them. If you're talking classic, they don't get much more classic than this. Love that roof. And it's not just classic cars they've got here, but a load of army and amphibious vehicles as well. That's very space 1999, isn't it? Imagine having that coming towards you up the river. could try running that in the canal, but I suspect the wheels would be touching the bottom. Just a thought. Shush now. These are camouflaged. They don't want us to see them. Mustn't speak too loud in case they get spooked. Another classic camper. Isn't that a thing of beauty? Ooh, that's lovely, that is. It is army-tastic.
This is Rex, Sally.
And if you fancy going on an expedition, one of these should do it. This is rather fantastic. As well as boats, since this was a boat show, and cars, there was also an extensive display of vintage bicycles and tricycles. And yet more vintage cars. Even a vintage caravan. Something for everyone in this lot. Look at that. Clearly American, but I don't know what it is. If you do, please drop a comment below. There was a handful of stalls selling mostly boating miscellany, but also, slightly bizarrely, bonsai trees.
It's just gone midday. I've been invited out on one of the Dunkirk classic boats for their parade this afternoon, so I'm going to pop back to the van, have a spot of lunch, and then turn up back at the boat ready for that parade.
This was the weekend of the heatwave in Britain, though on this Saturday it hadn't hit its peak. But pity the folk whose cars were in the sun. My van was under there.
Oh my, you can really feel it when you stand under the tree. It's so much cooler. Lovely.
There really is much to be said for taking a camper van as your everyday vehicle to events like this, because when you want to come back, have a spot of lunch, you can chill out in your own space, you've got food that you brought with you, chilled drinks in the fridge, and it really works. I should have had a camper van years ago. It's the perfect vehicle.
It is now mid-afternoon. It is very, very hot, though the van is still staying cool in the shade. I've done pretty much all the filming of the boat event I need to do, except that tonight there is an illuminated parade of boats, which I thought might make a nice final shot. So what I think I'm actually going to do is just have a little nap in the van and then wake up in time for the illuminated parade. And then I need to take the van, somewhere else to actually park it up overnight. Although I'm beginning to wonder whether I could just get away with sleeping in the van here, because I can't imagine anyone's going to be too worried about people sleeping in their vans at midnight. So we'll see.
The air was so still and warm, it was no surprise to spot a hot air balloon gently drifting along.
It's 9:30 and it's just beginning to get dark. The illuminated boat parade is supposed to start in about 15 minutes, so I'm going to head back over towards the river.
The filming was not a huge success, as both the camera and I struggled to get focus in the dark, and I decided to see if a spot I'd seen on the Park for Night app would be a nice place to snooze overnight. It was only a mile or two away, but involved yet more single-track roads, this time in the dark. And yes, I did meet people coming the other way.
In a quarter of a mile, you will arrive at your destination.
Oh, you've got to be kidding me. Ow.
And I made space for this one, as there was a pull-in on the left.
There we go.
Then at the bottom, had to wait for this lot packing up their car, which eventually they did, and I managed to get a space.
Well, good morning. It's a nice little car park, but it's ever so tiny and it's ever so packed.
I wouldn't recommend here. I only just squeezed the van in. Another blazing day was in the offing.
The reason it's so popular is because of what's down the end.
And that is a small slipway onto the Thames, where people bring canoes and kayaks and paddleboards, and, as you can see, camp up overnight like I did.
Access to the Thames, where happy dogs can swim in the water.
It was too hot for a walk, so I pottered home. Cheerio.